Hello and welcome back, dear friends. It's me, Odo. I'm back in my campaign of Pathfinder, Wrath of the Righteous, and let's do some more fighting. Ha! Our smaller army now fighting a few spiders. Let's do some magic missiles. Ooh, fancy. Let's do more magic missiles. Good. Let's do some more scorching ray. Some more magic missiles. Interesting, another blip. Okay, let's try to kill them. Thank you. Well done. They can do some more webs if they like to. I really don't care. Ooh, nice. This was a much easier fight than I thought. Yay, we're so great. We are so great. Yay. Spiders are not really hard to fight. Okay, we got Chainmail of Dragonfly, medium armor chainmail. This plus 3 chainmail can be activated once per day to grant all allies in a 30-foot radius a plus 1 insight bonus, dexterity, and to attack rolls against demons for 10 rounds. Ooh, nice. The grove had long been dry and dead. The spiders that once occupied it have been slaughtered. Monstrous web cocoons hang from the branches containing the remains of their victims and a certain number of useful items that miraculously were not dissolved in the spider's grove. Nice, nice, nice. Okay, level 6 army. Go back. Level 8 army. Should we also fight this demon army? I mean, it's just a level 7 army. It has some fire elementals. They can probably do some long-range damage. Melee slam. Burning extra planary. No, they don't have any range damage. Yeah, let's kill them as well. Why not? Probably we should have spared them and only done them next day. Probably I'm doing this too fast. Do they have immunity to something? They have immunities to fire. So if I take an ice bomb, I will do damage, yeah. Okay. Seems not too bad. And another stone elemental. Oh, come on. You must be joking. Kill them just. Interesting. Okay. Yeah. This fight more or less done. Ah, I see. Because all of the of these guys are dead again. This is the reason why I'm okay. Let's do Lay on Hands stealth, and then let's just kill him. We flank him. Okay. Good, 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 good. These are really, really bad units. I hope I could get rid of them, or at least make them better. Okay. We found a treasure. Unexpectedly, the enemy leader's tent turns out to be ship shape and tidy. Behind glass, an Arcanamirium magical college diploma hangs on a post. In the chest, there is a ceremonial graduation robe, and several magical inventions and patents. Brain children of the late cultist leader. One can only speculate on the tragedies that made him lead such a wretched. We found the treasure, eye for an eye. A composite short bow. 6 to 11 enhancement plus 3. Whenever this plus 3 composite short bow lands a hit on an enemy, the enemy suffers an additional 1d12 piercing damage. Nice. Okay, let's accept it. Let's move back a bit. Crusader army. What are you? Ah, mongrel sharpshooters. They probably could go. Here. Sharpshooters sounds nice at least. Also, we have three, we have already 4 melee units, no, 5 melee units, and only one, ranged unit, so these will be a good addition to what we already have there. Okay, fine. Let's go back. And now do the things that we wanted to do before. Go to bed. Shouldn't drink such loud. Come on. Be a bit faster. Let's give Venduak all this view of these things. Let's see if we can give Venduak a thing or two. She's also a ranged fighter. Four to 9 points of them. What merciless shot? Level 9 armor, quite fine. Let's go to bed.
Little one, what are you doing in the middle of this war? The battlefield is no place for children.
It's no place for anyone. But I've already had a longer life than many. So if I get killed, it doesn't really matter.
Okay. Good, so we are rested. Then, let's move out, I guess. The streets or area exits, temple barracks, half measure tavern. To the streets. Sid, I don't know how to do this night gambler thing. I mean, this Aeon thing means I have to do judgment on all the people running around with the stars around them. Which is probably stupid. Because it would also mean my lover, Darren, to be... Ick, you and I. And hold on. Ah, this is one of the military council guys. Oh, okay, first of all, let's move like here and do some trading. Come on. You can do it, you and your pig. Peasant, citizen, peasant, noble, citizen. Oh, chat. Hello? Would you please not run away? Wait, what? Ah, because there was this this tower in the way. Ah, come on. Really must. Where is there some good trade partner? Wolchief, citizen, peasant. Oh, there is the blacksmith. Let's sell stuff to the. Handaches, agile. Handaches plus 4. Ah, probably this is his second. Wait, what is this heavy mace of fire? Bedwork? Yeah. Let's move this away. Wait, what's this? Can we use the brew potions? Yeah, let's keep it. Why not? We should sell stuff from here. We really don't need all of that. I'm pretty sure about that. Like the inflict light wounds. I really don't think we need that. Serious and critical. Yeah, well. Really don't think we need lead blade. Summons elemental. Could be useful sometimes. Okay. Anything else? Nope. Not a dime. Would be nice if they would go like here where we can do some things. If we go there, will there be anything to be done? Where is the graveyard? I mean, we tried to wait there for midnight and no one was there, so probably not time related. Talk to her. We are being attacked by demons with unusual powers. Know anything about them? Back in Alushinira, there were rumors about terrible experiments that Baphomet and Descari performed on their to make them small. Here on the material plane, these rumors were embellished with lots of detail. Some say demons undergo rituals acquired from Sonkuton. Others say they feed on the blood of angels or Klipots, or demon lords. Still others say that there are no experiments and Baphomet is just bringing back fighters from the future. Future in which the demons have already taken all of Golarion. Okay. Is there a grain of truth in any of these ramblings? There's no way to know. Naturally, none of these rumors give any indication of where these demons come from. I'm sorry, I can't help. Why did I even ask you? What are you doing here? I really would like to know that. I'm watching. I'm listening to their conversations. Studying their faces. I'm trying to understand what they truly are. Don't you think you're being a little creepy? What? Sukus blinks, surprised. Really? Why? I don't mean any harm. Why do you like to watch mortals? You know, when I, in my old life, I thought I knew everything about them. I was a master of seduction, after all. I knew how to tempt a mortal into doing anything I required. I could trap them in a lie or lie myself and never get caught. It's disgusting to remember, but that was my life for many centuries. Now I see... I knew nothing. A demon warrior probably also considers himself an expert on mortals because he's killed so many of them. He certainly knows where to thrust the spear for a quick death and where to thrust it for a long and painful wound. And he thinks that's enough. My knowledge, it was of the same kind. I ruined many mortals without learning the first thing about them. Now I watch them to understand them. This won't give my victims back their lives, of course. Still, by growing closer to these mortals, it's like I'm paying back some part of my debt to my victims' memories. They love cats. Yeah, you're right. Arushale speaks in a very serious manner, as if sharing an important scientific discovery with you. But then a moment later she smiles to give the joke away. Seriously, have your observations of humans led to anything? I wouldn't want to draw any rash conclusions. I've only been watching them for a short while, but I think I have understood one thing. Yeah? The Ukubi have a saying, mortals always lie. If a mortal isn't talking, means she's busy lying to herself. But now I see this isn't true. You mortals aren't liars, you're dreamers. Each of you creates a huge daydream for yourself and everyone you share your life with. It isn't exactly a lie, because the daydream is your truth. Okay. I don't think that this is making it better, but If you think so, may I ask you a personal question? No, I don't want to know anything about yourself. Why should I say that? I mean, I took her in with me. What do you think of the powers I gave you? It's a great temptation. I don't know if I should be trusted with such power. I certainly wouldn't trust myself with it. When you have so much power, it's easy to decide. You're a god and mortals are your toys. Perhaps I should wait until after we defeat the forces of the Abyss. But that's precisely what these powers are for. You take a great risk. I'm not sure I can handle the temptation. Not enough as it is. If I say that, will she leave? You're right. You're right 1,000 times over, but still, I had hoped. No, we won't do that, of course. You may stay if you continue to serve the Crusade faithfully. Yeah. Okay. So, what are we doing? Horse, peasant, noble. Can't even speak. Can you? Interesting. I really don't know what to do with that. Okay. Let's move out then. Yeah, I will stop here for today. Next time when you see me, we will be away from Drezen already again. Because I will do this in between episodes. Until then, see you. Bye.